The king has come to see the results of the cleaning. Rodolfo and John hope that with his approval, they will be able to move on to Mustang's other crumbling monasteries. The consensus, a job well done. But something's not quite right. For the king, the conservators' work isn't finished. They must complete the deities by filling in the missing pieces.
They should try to paint the remaining part as it was before. We need the assistance of the experts to help us restore the art as it was in the past. Then it will be good. But if the restoration does not complete the art, then it will do more harm than good. We have to worship what is there.
The art inside Thubchen is fraught with cracks and missing pieces. To the people of Lo, these imperfections deface the living gods. In some places, they literally cut the gods in half.
Here we have to reconstruct enormous areas of painting. In Europe, we would have left it just as we found it, in a very, let's say, archaeological way. But this is not the concept these people have. They need the complete image.
The king and Kempo have asked Lama Guru to assess the situation.
You can see here that the two points do not match.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a very thin crack. And so in this case, I was thinking to just leave the crack.
That way.
In that way. It's too light. So darkened. Darkened in a way that the eye doesn't catch the crack by itself.
Yeah, and otherwise it looks a little bit of scar. You know?
Exactly.
Lama Guru sees the cracks as scars, deforming the deities.
This art has its own meaning. It is not for the sake of art. So in this work, one has to think from the point of view of the local people. Restoration, in the sense, means anything such damaged has to be restored completely. That is very, very important from the point of view of Tibetan Buddhism.
It's another way of seeing art here. Art is not as we see it, but it's part of daily life here. It's not a way of saving it and putting it into a crystal box, but we live in contact with it.
However sympathetic to the views of their Buddhist hosts, the conservators believe their role is to preserve what's there, not interpret what's missing. Rodolfo will complete the paintings in some areas, but he will use delicate cross-hatching to differentiate his work from the original.
This restoration with watercolors can be removed at any time.
And the final product to the naked eye integrates the watercolors into the painting as a whole. But where the gaps are enormous, Thubchen may be scarred beyond repair.
You can see here, we have this white plaster and then the drawing of what is missing. So we complete an image without painting, without interpreting, but only by a single red line. That is a compromise between the West and the East. So I think this is a good way of matching and respecting both ideas.
But the people want the paintings completed. And if they have to, they'll find someone who can do it.
When we see the incomplete and damaged murals, we feel something is missing. There are many such instances in the history when the Buddhist monasteries, arts, and idols has been damaged. But every time, somebody takes the initiative to restore it.
If they want to pay a good painter, I should say, should be an excellent painter, a great master, because the way of painting of the original is, I think, impossible. It would be extremely costly, firstly. Then, secondly, the quality of painting and feeling this kind of art, I think, is each period is belongs to the time. So I don't know. If they want to paint with commercial paints, acrylic paints, it's up to them.